Now I'm actually going to move this picture out of the way. It's actually become distracting with the person and all this unnecessary information. I'm just going to draw this diagram, which boils out the essential information. One thing I'd like to point out before we keep solving this problem. Delta y. Now in reality, the ball starts at ground level, goes up to some maximum height, and then ends at ground level. Since it starts and ends at the same altitude, well, delta y is really equal to zero. So maybe I shouldn't call it delta y. Instead, let's solve for the maximum height the ball reaches. So just like I did before, I'm going to approach this problem by looking at the vertical component first. Now actually, this seems like it could be pretty difficult. I've only got two pieces of information. But that's not entirely true. So let's exploit the one other fact we know about one-dimensional motion. We know that when an object reaches the absolute peak of its trajectory, its vertical velocity is zero, aka, at this point, Vy equals zero. It's also true that an object spends just as much time going up in its trajectory as it does going down. That's not something I'm going to prove for you here, but it's something you should definitely talk about in the forums. What's also true is that when a ball starts and ends from the same altitude, same height, it takes the exact same amount of time to go up as it does to go down. We could say t up equals t down. Okay, now we're getting somewhere. Let's use this equation. Well, I know at the highest point, the ball's vertical velocity is zero. The total velocity isn't zero because it's still moving towards the right, but it's not moving at all vertically. And that equals the initial vertical velocity plus acceleration times time, and this is where we have to be careful. Acceleration here is negative 10. Once I choose the initial velocity upwards of 40, acceleration is downwards, has to be negative, times time. If I solve this, I find that the time is equal to 4 seconds. Now, can you tell me what I should put here if this time represents the total travel time of the ball going up and then back down? I'll give you a hint, the answer is not 4.